Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to discuss about one circuit analysis problem related with the reciprocity theorem. So already I posted the two reciprocity theorem problems in the previous video. Okay, so if you want to learn that video, I will give link for those videos in the description box. You can refer it. Okay, and the remaining topics of the circuit analysis is also available in my channel. Okay, so from starting Ohm's law, KVL, KCL to that all things, mesh analysis, nodal analysis, then the different theorem, current division theorem, voltage division theorem, okay, source transformation, superposition theorem, reciprocity, and all problems all solved, and the videos posted in the playlist of circuit analysis. Okay, so if you want to learn that videos, I will give a link in the description box or in my channel, in the name of circuit analysis, one playlist is there, you can refer. Okay, so now we are moving to this video. Verify reciprocity theorem and find the current flowing through 4-ohm resistor. This is the question. So you see, this is the given diagram. So here, which one is input source? The 10-volt battery. Okay, this is the input source. And already you know, the reciprocity theorem is applied for single source circuit. That is, the circuit must consist of only one source. Okay, so yes, the circuit consisting of only one source, and it is valid for linear circuit and it is valid for bilateral circuit. Okay, so here a single source, it is a 10 volt battery, and the question is that current flowing through this 4 ohm resistor. So this current I is the output. Okay, this is our response, this is our excitation. Okay, so we have to verify the reciprocity theorem. So according to reciprocity theorem, so you know, first we have to, in first step, we have to, because of this input, what is the current flowing through the 4 ohm resistor, you just find out. Then you find the ratio V divided by I. V is nothing but the input voltage, I is nothing but the output current. Okay, then in second step, we have to interchange this voltage and current. Okay, so this input voltage source, you place here. Okay, so where we are measuring the current, you know, where we are taking the response, in that place, you place this input source and you have to measure current here. Okay, at the time, we can get some current. At the time, you just find the ratio V divided by I, and this V divided by I is always equal to the first V divided by I, means the reciprocity theorem is verified. Okay, so this is the thing. If you want to learn more about this reciprocity theorem, already I explained in the first, okay, in the previous video. If you want to learn, first learn what is reciprocity theorem and the definition and how to verify it, you just learn and watch this video. Okay, so now we can see. So first step, in the given circuit, the resistor 4 ohm, 2 ohm and 5 ohm connected in parallel. Okay, and our aim is to find out the current flowing through this 4 ohm resistor. And you know, in parallel connection, voltage across each resistor remains same. Okay, you see, parallel to this 5 ohm, 2 ohm, 4 ohm, the 10 volt battery is there. So voltage across 5 ohm is also 10 volt. Voltage across 2 ohm is also 10 volt. Voltage across 4 ohm resistor is also 10 volt. Okay, so the voltage across 4 ohm, you know, resistance value, you know, means we can find the current flowing through this branch using Ohm's law. Okay, so using that Ohm's law, the current I is equal to voltage across the particular branch divided by the particular resistance. Okay, what is the voltage across this 4 ohm resistor? 10 volt. So 10 divided by 4. Okay, so you see the current flowing through the 4 ohm resistor, I 4 ohm is 10 divided by 4. It is a 2.5 amps. Okay, we calculated. Okay, so first step over. Then what is the second step? Second step is to, we have to interchange this input voltage source. Okay, we have to interchange this input and this output. We just interchange and draw the diagram. So where we are measuring the current, here we are measuring. So in the place of output response, you place this 10 volt voltage source. Okay, so you see, you place 10 volt voltage source in the particular branch and you just measure current in a place of input source. Okay, so in this branch, we have to measure current. Here we have to give voltage. Okay, this is the thing. So now you just measure what is the current flowing through this branch. Okay, so now you see here it is a short circuit. Okay, short circuit parallelly connected with a 5 ohm resistor, parallelly connected with a 2 ohm resistor and one battery and 4 ohm is there. Okay, so in that case, so you know short circuit principle. So if there is short circuit means we are taking one conductor, it is a short circuit. So through short circuit, the current flowing is maximum. Okay, so always in short circuit, current flowing is maximum. Yeah, so here parallel to this short circuit, there are two resistances there. So that's why the current, so for example, here one current I is flowing means, so this I, this total I is full and full flowing in short circuit, not in this resistor 5 and 2 ohm. Okay, so that's why there is no use of this 5 ohm resistor and 2 ohm resistor. Okay, so you see in the diagram, there is a short circuit between the parallel connection of 5 ohm and 2 ohm. Hence, no current will flow through this 5 ohm and 2 ohm. Full current is flowing through the short circuit. Okay, that's why the current from the voltage source flow through only this 4 ohm resistor. So if you are removing this two branch means only in the circuit, what are the two thing available? This battery and 4 ohm resistor is available. So current flowing through this 4 ohm resistor is this I. Okay, so what is the current flowing through this 4 ohm resistor? It is nothing but the 10 volt divided by 4 ohm. So 10 divided by 4, 2.5 amps. Okay, so if you are interchanging the voltage source and the excitation also, we can get the same current I. Okay, so the ratio V by I is same for the first step as well as the second step. So the reciprocity theorem is verified. Okay, and current flowing through this 4 ohm resistor answer is 2.5 amps. Okay, so this is the one type of problem. Okay, so in previous question, we solved one problem. So in that, the input source is a current source. Okay, so you see, in previous problem, we solved one question, you know, the input is current source, output is a voltage across some resistance. Okay, but in the second problem, we solved input is a voltage source, response is a current flowing through the particular resistor. Okay, so the two types of problem we solved. Okay, so you just learned that video in order to know the superposition principle. Okay, so thanks for watching my channel and please subscribe my channel for more videos. If you want to learn all videos related to this circuit analysis, okay, that is in my channel in the name of circuit analysis, one playlist is there. In that all lecture videos are available in order. Okay. Then in the name of circuit analysis MCQ, another one playlist is there. In that all important 2 mark problem as well as the 1 mark questions is given in the order you can refer it. Okay, so thank you. We will meet in the next video with one more theorem.